we find that cyanide is so powerful. Cyanide would have you acting against yourself, not to mention the Creator. He has no place in life today. Because if the Creator had a place in our life today, as much as we would like for it to be, then most certainly we would not be drinking carrot juice and wheatgrass juice. We would not be eating a cow that was made by a laboratory. So there we find that violation. Surmounting, right? A whole lot of it because of the cyanide. So we go back to the geneticists. Genetics plays a most important role. Why? Because when God made things, animals and plant, human beings, just name all species of living things. He placed the gorilla in Africa and the polar bear in Alaska. If you think that God made a mistake, all you have to do is to put each animal in the opposite environment that God made for it. Like the gorilla, place him in Alaska. You will find that he would die with pneumonia in less than a fortnight. Place the polar bear in Africa. You would find that he would succumb to the heat. It's unbearable because his cells were not designed to live in an environment so hostile as the one in the Serengeti Plain, which is hot. Likewise, the gorilla would say that the environment of the polar bear is hostile to his cellular structure. And what about the food of the gorilla? And the food of the polar bear? Well, we find that the food of the gorilla are berries, plants, and leaves, fruits. The diet of the polar bear, on the other hand, is flesh and blood. If we believe, like we always do, we believe in philosophy, we believe in everything, but we never know anything. We just don't know anything. We believe in a whole lot of things. Like I always say that I prefer to deliver myself to God than to believe in God, because there is uncertainty. The polar bear eats blood. Not so for the gorilla. He's plant. But now we look at the behavior of these two animals. We find that the gorilla is a very pleasant animal. He has no enemies in the forest. He raises his offspring just like we do. Just like we do, he raises his offspring. He's a pleasant animal. Not so for the polar bear. This animal eats blood. He has to kill to live. Because blood compels that animal to be vicious and savage. So he eats blood. We go to the birds. Eagle is a bird. So is a buzzard. And so is a hummingbird. That's a bird too. But the hummingbird, like the gorilla, he likes to indulge in the nectar of the plants. He has nothing to do with blood. He sucks the nectar from the plant. He's a very beautiful little bird. He's very gentle. Not so for the eagle. The eagle, on the other hand, eats blood, eats rats, eats snakes. But look at the disposition of the eagle and that of the polar bear, opposed to the hummingbird and the gorilla. we begin to see a biochemical interference. We apply that same example to the plants. Ladies and gentlemen, many of you that are acquainted with plants, like the burdock, the yellow dock, those are only two, the Virginia snake root. Those of you that are not acquainted with the plants in the tropics, the demagagua, the calawala, the cypress, these are powerful plants. These plants are responsible for us at the OSHA Research Institute reversing these pathologies or diseases. So you find that these plants also does not live in an environment that is inconsistent with their cellular and genetical structure. You will never find calawala grown in Canada, nor cypress, nor demagagua. That you will never find. Like you will never find the burdock in Central America, because these plants, the calawala, the demagagua, and the cypress, are plants that grows in the tropical region of the planet. You will never find those plants in America. Likewise, you will never find yellow dock, burdock, or even the one shepherd purse in Central America, because the climatic condition is inconsistent with the existence of those plants.